Okay, so in last lecture we discussed about full custom ASIC, its advantages and disadvantages. Now in today's lecture we will discuss about semi-custom ASIC based design technology, its advantages, disadvantages, and we will take two examples also. Now in semi-custom ASIC based design technology, basically there are two methods. One is standard cell based design and another is gate array based design. So we will discuss in today's lecture about the standard cell based design. Now in in last class we discussed about full custom ASIC, where an engineer has to design the layout of each and every transistor by himself. After completing the layout, he will generate one GDS2 file, and that GDS2 file has to be sent to foundry, where with the help of GDS2 file they will fabricate the design over silicon, right? So now during the preparation of the layout of all the transistor, it will take much time. After that, the production of the IC, right, or the fabrication of the logic over the silicon, again that will take huge time. So total time required for launching the product in the market is large in case of full custom ASIC based design. And in fact nowadays full custom ASIC design nobody is using, right? Suppose whatever is their design, few section only they will use full custom ASIC, and remaining section of their design they may use some other technology like semi custom ASIC or some other technologies which we will discuss in other lectures, right? So in case of semi custom ASIC, what will happen, the foundries, right, who are ultimately going to fabricate the logic over the silicon, what they will do, they will create the cells, and those cells are created at the layout level, right? So what they will do, they will assign the task of their design engineers that okay, this team A should prepare the layout of two input AND gate, team B will prepare the layout of two input NAND gate, team C will prepare the layout of suppose decoder, team D will prepare the layout of D flip flop. So like this, they will allocate the work to various teams, and those teams will prepare the layout of those type of digital components, right? And finally, when the layout will be prepared, see, for the preparation of the layout they have to draw the layout at the transistor level, right? And once the layout is prepared, they will create one cell of that layout, right? Now once the cell is created, now suppose as a design engineer, I have to design suppose a half adder. We will take the same example which we discussed in last class. So I have to design a half adder. So what I will do now, instead of designing the whole half adder at the MOSFET level, instead of designing the layout of whole half adder at the MOSFET level, what I will do, I can take the cells which are already designed by foundries, right, fabrication companies, and those cells I can simply take and I can interconnect those cells, and then I will generate the GDS2 file. Okay, so now what will happen? Earlier case in full custom ASIC, a design engineer has to design the layout of all the MOSFETs, right? So we discussed in case of half adder, 28 MOSFETs are required. So engineer has to design the layout of all the 28 MOSFETs. But now what will happen? This designing of the layout of these MOSFETs are already done, right? In the form of cells. So I will simply take that cell and make the interconnection. That's all. My work is completed, right? So now the designing of the layout part will be very easy for me, right? So for me, there is no need to design the layout of each and every MOSFET. This work is already done by the foundry people, and after making the layout, they will give those cells to the design engineer, and we can use those cells and we can simply interconnect those things, right? So here, for example, let us see, this is suppose cell C1, right? This is already designed by the foundry people. So this C1 may perform suppose two input AND gate operation. So layout of this two input AND gate operation at the MOSFET level is already done, and this cell is available to me. Same way, there is another cell C2, there is another cell C3, like this C4, C5, C6, C7, C8. So maybe in my design, I require these cells C1 to C8. Now what I will do? I will interconnect C1 cell and C2 cell. After the interconnection, I will get another block, that is F1. Now, by interconnecting C3 and C4, I will get another block F2, right? Now, by interconnecting C7 and C8, I will get another block F3, right? And now here, what I will do, I will interconnect F1 and C6 and F3. And after interconnecting these, I will get the final design. Right, as per my requirement, I am doing the interconnection. So what I am doing, I am not designing the layout, right? Simply I am using the cells whose layout is already designed by the foundry people. Now let us see here, this is the layout of NOT gate, right? This is the layout of NOT gate. So this layout preparation is already done by the fabrication company, and this NOT gate is available for me as a cell. Let us assume this C1 is this NOT gate, right? So already the layout is already available. Now this is the layout of two input NAND gate, right? Two input NAND gate. Here you see this M2. This M2 is one MOSFET. It is this PMOS is there, and this M1 is another MOSFET is there, right? Another MOSFET is there. Here, this is NMOS, right? This is also the layout of NOT gate only, right? This is the layout of NOT gate, right? So in this way, these layouts are prepared by the fabrication company, and as a cell, it is available to me. As a design engineer, I can use these cells and I will simply do the interconnection. After doing the interconnection, I will get the final design, right? Maybe the final design is this much complex layout, right? So in this way, once the final design is ready, only simply by interconnecting the cells, now this final design will be generated in the form of GDS2 file, right? And this GDS2 file I will send to foundry. I will send this GDS2 file to Foundry. Now what Foundry people will do, they will fabricate this layout over silicon, right? They will fabricate this layout over silicon, and finally I will get the IC. So now this fabrication process, this step is still there, right? But the designing of the layout of each and every MOSFET is not there, because that is already done by Foundry people, and I am simply using those layout as a cell in my design. So that time I can save that time, right? Designing of the layout of the MOSFET will be saved in this case, right? Okay. Now we will take this one example. Example one, design of half adder, right? So already we know that in half adder I require two input XOR gate and two input AND gate, right? So let us assume this is one cell, right? This is one cell. So this cell is of XOR, two input XOR gate. So name given to this cell is XOR underscore 2. So here this 2 means it is a 2 input XOR gate cell. So this cell is designed at the MOSFET level, right, by the Foundry people, and it is available to me in this way. It is having two inputs, input 1 in one and in two, and it is having one output out, right? Same way, this is another cell. This is maybe we call it as cell number 2. The name of this cell is AND underscore 2. So see, we have to give some name which we can understand what is the purpose of this cell. So here AND means it is performing AND logic, and underscore 2 means it is two input AND gate logic, right? So this cell is also having two inputs, in one and in two, right? And one output, right? So these cells are internally designed at the MOSFET level, right? Layout is designed at the MOSFET level. So now as a design engineer, what I will do, my job is only to interconnect these cells as per my requirement. Now for my requirement for half adder, so now what I will do, I will connect XOR underscore 2 cell inputs with my input A and B. So these two are my inputs, simply I will connect with in 1 and in 2 of XOR underscore 2 cell, right? And the output is sum. This logic will give me sum. Now I will take another cell which is AND underscore 2, right? And this I will connect in one is connected to A input, and in 2 is connected to B input, right? And this cell will give me a carry logic, right? So now you see how much easy it is for a design engineer. I am not designing the layout of these 28 MOSFET, because in last lecture we discussed that for two input XOR and two input AND logic, I need 28 MOSFETs, right? I need 28 MOSFETs. Now, in full custom ASIC, the design engineer designed the layout of these 28 MOSFETs by himself, right? But now in semi-custom ASIC cell based design, what is done? Already cell has been created at the layout level by the Foundry people. Simply I will take these cells and I will make the interconnection, that's all. And finally, with the help of these interconnection, and finally I will generate GDS2 file, right? I will generate GDS2 file, and this GDS2 file will be given to Foundry people, and Foundry people will manufacture a IC, right? It will manufacture a IC, and this IC will perform the logic of half adder and it will have two input connections, right? And it will have two output connections, right? Inside this IC, there is a silicon. Over this silicon, 28 MOSFETs are fabricated, right? So this fabrication work is done by foundry, and already we have taken the cells of that particular foundry only. So for the fabrication, there will be no problem. They can fabricate the design. Okay. Now we will take another example, that is design of 3-bit full adder, right? So now in this case, what will be done? So let us assume that foundry has already designed this cell of full adder, right? Now see, for full adder, already we discussed in last class also, how many MOSFETs are required for a full adder. For full adder, for some, we have the expression A XOR B XOR C in, right? And for carry, we have the expression of A B or B C in or A C in, right? This is the expression. So for A XOR B, we need 22 MOSFETs, right? Yes, we require 22 MOSFETs, right? And whatever is the logic generated here, that is again XOR with C in. So here also we need 22 MOSFETs, right? And now here in this logic, for AB we require 6 MOSFETs, for BC in we require 6 MOSFETs, for AC in we require 6 MOSFETs, right? So this logic AB and BC in, this is ORed. For OR we require 6 MOSFET, right? And here for this OR we require 6 MOSFET. So total here we need 30 MOSFETs, right? So 30 for carry, and for sum 22 plus 22, 44. Okay. 22 only, na? We will see this expression for OR. A bar B plus A B bar. So here 2 MOSFET and this end 6 MOSFET. Here 2 MOSFET and this end 6 MOSFET. This OR 6 MOSFET. Yes, 22. So total we need 4 and this 74 MOSFET, right? So 74 MOSFETs are required for one full adder. 74 MOSFETs are required, right? And if you want to design 3-bit full adder, this means here this is one full adder, then this is another full adder, and this is another full adder, right? This is another full adder. So for one full adder, we need 74. So here we require 74 MOSFETs. For this full adder, we need 74 MOSFETs. For this full adder, we need 74 MOSFETs. So how many total MOSFETs are there? So this is 12 and 22. So 3-bit full adder, we need 222 MOSFETs, right? Now if we will design this 3-bit full adder by using ASIC technology, then then we have to design the layout of these 222 MOSFETs by ourselves, right? By using Tanner tool or Cadence software, right? Whatever software you want, you can use that. So here, lot of time is required to draw the layout of this 222 MOSFET. But now, what will be done in semi-custom ASIC, right? In semi-custom ASIC, what will be done? Already the foundry people have designed the layout of this full adder. So, right, this is the layout of full adder. You can see this is the input A, this is the input B, and this is the C in, this is the output sum, and this is the output C out. So, right, so here already this layout is having 24 MOSFETs. By using 24 MOSFETs, this layout is already created by the foundry people, and this full adder is available for me as this cell. Now what I will do as a design engineer, instead of designing the layout of 74 plus 74 plus 74 MOSFETs for 3-bit full adder, now simply I will connect this cell, three cells, that's all. My work is completed, right? So it will be done like this, in this way. What I will do, I will take this full adder cell FA. This is three input, 1, 2, 3, right? Having two outputs, S0 and this carry. Then I will take another cell. So what I will do, the output of the carry output of first, I will make the interconnection. Right, I will make the interconnection with the carry input of the second full adder. Then this full adder will generate some S1, and this carry output is again connected to the C in of third full adder. Right, in this way I will simply make the interconnection. I will not work at the layout level. So it is very easy for a design engineer to take these cells and interconnect. So very less time is required, right? So immediately after making these interconnection, what I will do, I will generate GDS2 file. Okay, GDS2 file, and this file I will send to foundry, and foundry people from GDS2 file, they will manufacture this IC, right? And this is my three they will manufacture this IC. This IC will have two, three inputs, right? Like this, and it will have two outputs. These three outputs for sum and one for C out, right? So here the inputs are A2, A1, and A0, right? And this is B2, B1, and B0, and here this is C out, S2, S1, and S0. So this is my 3-bit full adder IC, and this IC is having 222 MOSFETs, which are fabricated over the silicon, right? So this fabrication, so now you just see, in case of semi-custom ASIC, fabrication of the IC, this process is still there, right? But the designing of the layout of the MOSFETs, that process has been removed now, right? So there is no need to draw the layout. Simply I will use the cells and interconnect. So now some time I can save. So whatever time earlier I was consuming in drawing the layout of the MOSFETs, so that time I can save now, right? So by using semi-custom ASIC, what will happen? The time to market will reduce now, right? Because I have saved some time. Okay, so this is about the semi-custom ASIC design technology.